everyone at the Utica Zoo.
Hi everyone, it's Kathleen with Utica Zoo, and today I'd like to introduce you to our opossum, Daisy. Now Daisy has actually been living here at the Utica Zoo for almost 2 years now. She actually came to us as a rescue, so if you remember our video about Grace, who was also a rescue animal, Daisy here was a rescue from the wild. Unlike Grace, who got injured in the wild, Daisy was actually found when she was very, very small, way too little to be out and about on her own. And so she was taken into captivity and hand-raised from a very young age. And since she never really learned what it was like to be a possum out in the wild, we adopted her here at the zoo from the rehabber so that she would have a place to stay where she could grow, get hand-fed, she wouldn't have to worry about the things or not knowing what to do in the wild. So Daisy and opossums are very unique animals to our area as well as our country because they are actually the United States' only marsupial. Now marsupials are animals that carry their young in a pouch like a kangaroo, or here at the zoo we also have our wallabies that are also marsupials, but they're the only animal that lives in North America that has a pouch. And they carry their young in their pouch until they get a little bit too big, don't quite fit in there anymore. And then they actually still stick with mom for a while. They kind of ride right along mom's back, and she takes care of them until they're big enough, old enough that they can go out and about on their own. In addition to being a marsupial, possums are also what we call nocturnal. And what nocturnal means is it's an animal that stays up at night and sleeps during the day. Now you might be wondering, we are filming this during the day and Daisy is awake right now. And that's mostly because she lives here at the zoo. She has a little bit of a different schedule than most of the possums do. But most of the time, possums are more active at night when it's a lot darker outside. Now, possums don't have very good eyesight, but since it is so dark outside when they come out, they don't really need to have good eyesight. So instead, they rely on their very, very keen sense of smell, as well as their hearing, and they also have a pretty good sense of touch as well. So when they're moving around in a forest or a marsh, or even sometimes in a city, these guys can kind of feel around, smell, and hear, and that kind of helps them to figure out where they're going. The other thing that possums sometimes get a bad reputation for is the way that they look. Now, unfortunately, because we have such cold upstate New York winters up here, it can be pretty cold for an animal like a possum. And since they don't have any hair or fur on their ears and on their tails, a lot of the times in the wintertime they can get frostbite and have to deal with a lot of those things. They don't hibernate like other mammals do. So when people see them looking the way that they do, they instantly think, oh my goodness, this possum has rabies. But believe it or not, it is actually very, very rare for a possum to carry rabies. Their body temperature is a little bit lower, and that actually prevents them from really being able to carry rabies. So it's very, very uncommon for a possum to carry rabies. And in addition to that, possums are incredibly helpful animals because one of their favorite things to eat is ticks. Now, an individual possum like Daisy, these guys can eat about 5,000 ticks a year, just one possum. So just imagine if you had a couple possums in your backyard, they'd be eating all those ticks and getting rid of an animal or a bug that can cause Lyme disease, which is not a very good thing. So possums are actually very, very helpful animals, very helpful creatures to us here in New York, as well as throughout North America. Thank you guys so much for joining us today and for visiting with our possum, Daisy. Be sure to check out our website at uticazoo.org/kazoo for some fun activities about possums and about other nocturnal animals that live here at the Utica Zoo. And if you have a question about Daisy or about any of the animals so far that you've seen in our kazoo videos, be sure to send them to us. You can send us an email or even send them by mail, and they might be featured in one of our next kazoo videos. Thank you guys so much.